comments? Do you want to speak?
Any comments to make? What did that, is it called, man?
I'm looking on this list that somebody has signed. Harold Smith?
I have a question first. You stated it would be 715 feet from the closest residence. Is that, I mean, that's the existing residence right now, right?
That's right, yeah.
Okay. So if you're talking about development in front of the solar farm, it would certainly be residence that is much closer.
Right, right.
So you're talking about developing property that is very close at that point?
Yes, yeah, it'd be closer.
Then those would have to abide by the 100-foot setback provision.
No, Brian, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think the ordinance says that when you build the solar farm, you have to make sure it's at least 50 or 100 feet from any existing residence at the time. Is that right?
That's correct.
Not the right. So the new development, the residences in that development would be closer than 715 feet, but I think they'd still be further than 100 feet away.
And this has changed since it says 750, but it's really closer to 1,000 just because of the way.
I'm not concerned with where we are, with the existing. I am concerned with those, but I'm more concerned with the potential development of that property. I'll just go on with my comments if you don't mind. My primary concern is that you're considering a conditional use permit for residential property, period. We know that the town has a limited amount of land that's available for residential development. We also know there's land elsewhere whose owners are more than willing to accommodate these companies. And I don't have anything against O2 energy or solar energy in general. I understand that you guys have a reputation for doing the right thing and for keeping your commitments. The ordinance stipulates a setback of 50 feet from subdivision roads and 100 feet from residential structures. That is about the distance from the back of this room to the house next door. Okay? Now imagine waking up in the morning, peering out your upstairs bedroom window, the glorious array of Lisbon solar panels. No vegetative buffer is going to fix that. And I don't know of many people who are going to build, purchase land and build adjacent to it. I'm asking if you allow this land to be developed in the manner in which you originally intended. Do we really want to occupy our limited amount of residential property for the next 25 years or longer with solar panels? We're also concerned that granting this special use permit will open the door for other companies to establish similar projects in other residentially zoned areas of the town. If this permit is approved, it won't be a matter of simply saying no after you set this precedent. I've watched this grow. Town Chalkwood and the town board is to be commended for the job that you've done and the good, controlled growth. But this isn't the future, I don't think, that most residents in this town had envisioned, and it's not what we had in mind, what y'all had in mind when you developed the zoning plan. It just doesn't fit with the good, controlled growth that we've experienced to this point. I'm going to ask you to do two things. Number one, I want you to be prudent. The only experts that have been consulted regarding solar farms and how they impact communities are representatives of O2 Energy who want to construct. Please talk to an expert on the advantages and disadvantages of solar farms and how they impact communities before you make a decision. I have contact. I'll be glad to provide you with the name and contact information of someone who would be helpful to you. And secondly, I want you to consider the opportunity costs of its potential use before tying up this property for the next 25 to 50 years. I don't know how long, okay? The opportunity cost of its potential uses. That's all I have to say, and I appreciate you letting me call.
Jeff.
Mr. Mayor, I have 4 points to bring in opposing the R3 zoning ordinance, and I understand fully that the decision is what you will do with the ordinance. Has zero to do with this company. It could be company XYZ sitting here in these seats. And so my concern and my direction of influence is to you, not to this company. And the creating a conditional use to allow solar farms is not in the best interest long-term for our town. My first point. Any R3 zone on your map, that's marked draft map, this is current zoning map, Brian?
That is pretty close to the current zoning map, that's correct, yes.
And that's what's displayed.
Correct.
So, anywhere that's marked R3 on this map would meet, the town would have to consider anybody that came in an R3 district to allow that as conditional use, not just this one piece of property. So, I live on this side of town, some of you live on this side of town. I would suggest that you look at that map and see areas that are around you. I did not see anything in the ordinance that address acreage. Is that correct? There's nothing about acres, correct?
No limited acres, that's correct.
So, when you look on that, there's parcel in front of the mayor's house. There's other parcels around. So, again, I agree with what Harold said. We want you to look at the impact of the whole town and the possibilities of the whole town, not just the consideration of that tract of land for this company. My second point is you have adopted in the past your land use plan, which is a state requirement. And that land use plan was adopted February 2nd, 1998, your most recent. I think it's like 10 years that that's done. That's a state requirement, correct, Ron? Is that right?
That's correct, but the most recent, Jeff, and not to just to point out, the most recent Campbell land use plan that the town is working under now,
okay,
were folded under Beaufort County, and that was a 2006 plan.
Okay.
And I do have a copy if anyone would like to,
okay,
to peruse that.
And the purpose of that plan, and look, some of you may not know, but Bryant works with Minnie's Commission, and he is working as a planner with the town. It's his job. Okay. Maybe I shouldn't have explained that, but I think it's fair. A lot of people know that.
Thank you, Jeff.
And so that's a requirement that town has to meet other state requirements and things they participate in. The board that works on that, my understanding is they look at trying to see what lands are around, how the town is developing long term, and make some recommendations. Now, it's a plan. Plans change. I understand that. But at the same time, they're given the task of trying to see in that crystal ball what is the best makeup of the town long term. Okay. Is that fair, right?
That is correct.
Okay. So, again, to the board, because the five of you will make this decision, I suggest that you look hard at decisions that have been made long-term based on things you have implemented, and what will be the purpose of that plan, okay? Probably my larger point that I would like to make to this board is that the town taxpayers and utility customers have invested a lot of dollars to build two water mains and two sewer mains that pass along the property on Vergal Lane. I know the property is set there, it's been for sale, understand that. I think if you want to make that argument, that's fine. I would turn around and challenge that argument with the Hill property that has been for sale. That property was purchased, and now through, you know, just being patient and good guidance, you have a nice development that's coming there, okay? And so I would suggest to you to look at how the town is developing, what investments are done currently. This parcel was an ideal location to eventually develop as residential as zoned and become part of our town. The current development you have approved on the Hill Farm is an example of positive growth. A solar farm in the town limits or ETJ, because we're not just talking about the town limits, but we're talking about, is it 2 miles outside of town?
It's 1 mile.
1 mile. Some areas get 2 miles or a mile and a half. But, so anything that you approve would be applicable in the town limits as well as the ETJ, the extraterritorial jurisdiction. And this is not an example of positive growth, I do not believe. I encourage you to utilize our investments in water sewer close to town and not extending out to areas that are not growing the town. The long-term growth and development of Chalk Community is entrusted in your hands, the five of you. This company, their sales pitches, their reps, they will be moving on to some other project. I understand that. Our families, our citizens, those of you that live here all your lives, we will still be here to live with decisions that you make. So I ask you not to change the ordinance to accommodate solar farms. Thank you.
Many of y'all have seen some of the solar farms in Bath, and we just thought that there was a letter in the editor February 24th, and we just wanted to read that to y'all and just give you an idea of what one of the residents would say to our area as they heard that our town is considering a solar farm. Says to the editor, Beaufort County residents should get in their vehicles and ride up the Bath, which is at South White Coast, Millfield Road, and see Highway 92. You will want to see our newest asset, the solar farm. Then ask yourself, would I want this for my neighbor? With all the crude chain link fencing, barbed wire, and signage, it makes the area very unattractive for any future homeowners or even adjacent landowners. Even with the ordinance put in place by our county commissioners for solar farm setbacks, that was only a band-aid. But it was a start in the right direction. With solar farms and the Beaufort County Detention Center and Jail targeting the Chocolaty area, you folks may want to think this over. In the middle of a residential area, why would you even be thinking of that? Beaufort County needs some type of zoning put in place to protect the residents and taxpayers in this county from large commercial industrial projects. Maybe this needs to be on the next election ballot and a vote by the people. I'm a longtime resident and have had a successful business in Beaufort and surrounding counties for more than 30 years. I only want the very best for our area, with good positive decisions being made for future growth. In my line of work and doing business in other areas which have zoning regulations set in place, I have encountered no problems, thus making it a more equal playing field for everyone. No, I'm not for bigger government. The people, which are paying the price, should be more involved in the decisions being made in Beaufort County. That was written by Paul E. Bullard, Jr. And we agree. We have nothing against this company, but we prefer that it be built outside the town, not in the town.
Good. Erica, last.
I don't have a whole lot to say. I just want to let y'all know that we, as a group, all agree with Mr. Jeff, Mr. Harrell, and Mr. Jeff's wife. This is not what we envisioned when we moved to Chalk Community. My husband and I both are members of this community. We moved here in 2009. I'm the school nurse, and I plan on being here until I retire and longer. My husband works at BCS, and we plan on him hopefully being here and enjoying our town. We moved from Bath, and we came here because it was growing. And we picked our house, knowing that there wasn't a house beside us, but we were hoping that it would be more people, to have a bigger community, to enjoy a neighborhood, not a solar farm. And people are not going to want to come move beside the solar farm. I live there, I don't have anything against them, but I don't want to miss out my house, and I can't imagine anybody else wanting to move into a place where it's there.
All right.
May I ask one more question? Okay. One more. You said that the other land would be used for residential. How is that in the contract? I mean, is that land, is there any possibility of an extension of the solar farm to that land?
No, not really. When we sort of submit our application to the utility and we tell them what it is we want to interconnect to the grid, we're kind of locked into that. So there wouldn't be a chance to expand it. What would be built is what would be there, what we would, O2 Energies would own and operate and take care of long term.
No comments for facility.
I have somebody that signed up for 68 John Circle.
Yes, I'm Patrick Leonard. You can tell from my accent that I don't come from around here. I've lived in Chapel the area for the last 8 years, and much of what I wanted to say has been said already. I think the decision to give up land that's been zoned for residential for this purpose is short-sighted and not in the best interest of the community long term. I will lay you a bet that if you come back here 20, 30 years from now, that farm will be gone. There'll be nothing there. If you build houses on it, you can expect to get income from it for the next 70, 80, 200 years. Land that's zoned residential is very precious. And I think for us to give it up in this way, but there must be plenty of land around that is not in the residential area could be used for this purpose. And you're starting a precedent, which I believe would be very costly for this town if you go forward. Because there's going to stop other people coming in and saying, well, the precedent is there. We can't deny it to us if you gave it to them. Thank you.